Very good evening, dear friends. In this session, we will deal with the debentures, the meaning and definition of debentures. Debenture is a loan capital. Earlier, we discussed about shares, which is a share capital of the company. For the corporate governance, it is the shareholders who take decisions, but debenture holders have no say in the corporate governance, but they have got a say with regard to their securities, their money invested, and the refund of the debentures, which is mandatory under the provisions of the Companies Act. Friends, debenture is taken as one of the most important securities, providing long-term loan capital to the company. So, according to subsection 30 to section 2 of the Companies Act 2013, debenture includes debenture stock, bonds, or any other instrument of a company evidencing a debt, whether constituting a charge on the assets of the company or not. So there is no need to even put a charge on the company. If it evidences a debt, then a debt can be taken as a debenture. Then there are different definitions of the term debenture by several jurists and courts of law, both in India and England, and in England, of course, but the essence and meaning are absolutely one and the same. So basically, dear friends, the concept of debentures is originated from English law, as the case with the share capital and shares of the company. Now I take you to the different definitions of debentures, making it rather easy for you in the examination point of view. So number one, the chief controlling revenue authority versus manager, State Bank of Mysore, reported in 1918, volume 65, company cases, page 427. The Karnataka High Court observed that debenture is one of the means of raising funds by anyone, but generally by companies in the interest of trade, commerce and industry. Topham, a great writer, has written a book called Company Law. He defined in this book the debenture as a document given by a company as an evidence of a debt to the holder, usually arising out of a loan and most commonly secured by a charge. Palmer, the great jurist, in his work Company Law, defined debenture as an instrument under seal, evidencing a debt, the essence of it being the admission of indebtedness. Then the Bombay High Court in Lakshman Bharamji versus Emperor, reported in AIR 1946 Bombay, pre-independence, page 18, observed that the debentures normally indicate the security against the loan taken by the company, and they contain the conditions of repayment, most important, date, rate of interest, payable to the holder, and they may even create a charge on the company's property. Justice Chitty, he is also a great jurist and writer, in Levy versus Abercorris, State and Company, reported in 1887, volume 37, Chancery Division, page 216. He defined a debenture as a document which either creates a debt or acknowledges, and any document which fulfills either of these documents. So what we understand by all this discussion, the debentures are the acknowledgement of a debt by the company, and they are repayable after a particular stipulated period, unlike the share capital, because shares cannot be repaid unless the company is wound up. They can be transferred and then, of course, liquidity can be made out. But otherwise, no. But the debentures are transferable like the shares, but refundable, that is most important. So there is a lot of distinction between shares and debentures. The debentures are issued in the similar manner, of course, as of shares through prospectus, because they are called securities. The issue of shares and debentures is regulated by the guidelines and regulations of the Securities and Exchange Board of India. Under the Securities and Exchange Board of India Act and other corporate laws like the Securities Contract Regulation Act, the Depositories Act, etc., including, of course, FEMA. Section 71 of the Companies Act 2013 contains the various provisions pertaining to the debentures. It also describes the basic characteristics of the debentures. So, some of the characteristics I point out, friends. Number one, like tomorrow you can get a question as a debenture. Maybe this is not Companies Act, company law paper, but it is a regulation of the securities which you are studying in this paper. Obviously, you had to again travel through a little at least. So, the debentures constitute a loan of the company to the holder. They are the long-term loans of the company, and then the debenture holders are called the creditors of the company. The debenture holders are entitled to receive the stipulated rate of interest, whether the company gets any profit or not. Whereas the shareholders are concerned, unless profits are there, dividends will not be declared. Then the debenture holders are entitled to receive the interest, whether dividends are paid or not to the shareholders. Debenture holders cannot exercise any voting rights in corporate governance, but they can exercise class rights to protect their own interest. And debenture holders are, in fact, protected by issuing debentures against a charge on the assets of the company, whereas it is not possible with regard to the share capital of the company. Debenture is issued in the form of certificate under the name of the company, and they can be there, and the debenture is compulsorily repayable or in the alternative convertible into shares, of course. Then the debenture holders are protected by the debenture trustees and the trustee fund, and debentures are transferable, of course, like shares. So these are all the basic characteristics, and then they are absolutely different from the shares and the characteristics of the shares. Then what is debenture stock? Debenture stock is consolidation of the entire debentures into single account without carrying any face value for each debenture individually. As for example, debentures can be issued with a face value of 100 each into 1 lakh in number, thus totaling to rupees 1 crore. Even a single debenture of face value of 100 is transferable. In case of debenture stock, individual division of debenture with face value of 100 will not be possible, in fact, because that is a stock. The debenture stock is issued as rupees 1 crore for public subscription, and the holding of debenture holder will be in the form of debenture stock of, like, for example, rupees 20,000 or 20 lakhs and so on, in accordance with the holder's subscription. It will not be in the face value of rupees 100, so transferability is difficult. The stock holding is depicted in a consolidated form, and then other features of debenture stock holders are one and the same as in the case of debentures. So, in fact, the other aspects could be studied subsequently as and when we come across further this particular subject matter. At the moment, this is enough, because the elaborately about debentures we have studied in Companies Act under the company law paper earlier. Now, to the extent it is required for our securities and corporate laws, corporate and securities laws paper only, we are studying. So, friends, with this background, we close our discussion on the debentures. Then the next discussion on the derivatives, we will continue, in fact, in our next session. Thank you, dear friends. Good night. Goodbye. Thank you.